All right, how you doing, everybody? Chris Bruce here, real estate investor, nationwide coach, as well as the founder and top-rated podcast on iTunes called Escaping the REI Newbie Zone. Now, I'm here. I wanted to shoot this quick video to talk about one of the three top motivated sellers that you need to be targeting in 2018 and beyond. All right? I've actually been targeting these motivated sellers for a few years now, but I'm shooting this video in 2018, and I still believe that these are some three top motivated sellers to target. Now, there are other sellers that you can target. Don't get me wrong. You can literally find deals from anywhere if you put yourself in the right position, if you put yourself in the right place, and you're marketing. However, if you're just starting off, or if you're looking for a consistent flow of leads coming into your business, there's just three that you need to be targeting. All right, and I'm going to talk about those three. Now, you got to excuse my handwriting. I'm not the best person when it comes to manuscript, but you'll get the point. All right, number one. Vacant houses, okay? Vacant properties, all right? And the reason why is because you got to understand, as a wholesaler, you're looking for people that are in situations where, you know, they're going to be in a position where they need to sell, all right? And their property is vacant. That means that it's maybe somebody might have facing foreclosure. I don't know, maybe they just evicted the tenant. For whatever reason, its asset is no longer asset, it's a liability now because they're no longer making money off of the property. And they have to pay property taxes. And one of the things that you can use as a negotiation tool when there's a vacant property is that there's a little clause sometimes in some people's insurance policies where it states basically that if their house has been vacant for a certain amount of time, they do not have to keep insurance on the property, far as if something was to happen, they're not liable for it anymore because that person has had left the property vacant. And a lot of homeowners don't know this. So when we talk with sellers and we bring this up, this is a lot of times how we're able to get the property at a discounted low rate, because the fact that they don't know that if something was to happen, they would be, you know, responsible for that and their insurance wouldn't cover it. So vacant properties is definitely one that you want to target. Now, there's a few different ways. Of course, you can purchase a vacant list. We have a list available. There's softwares out there that you can purchase to get these lists. Or you can just do it old-fashioned way by driving around, looking for vacant properties, and writing the addresses down, coming back to your property appraiser's website, your local county property appraiser's website, putting the address in, finding out the new mailing address, and then picking up the phone to either skip tracings or try to phone them and call them, or just go ahead and send a quick letter or postcard to them. And that's how you can get in touch with them. Number two. Tax defaults, okay? People are in behind in their taxes. Now, let's face it, folks. A lot of people don't pay the taxes. A lot of people owe Uncle Sam. You know, the thing is that somebody that has a property, even if it's free and clear, they're responsible for taxes every single year. And these taxes can go up to $2,000, $3,000, you know, a year. And, you know, some people just can't afford to have that extra cash to pay those taxes. All right. And so they're behind a couple of years. And, you know, Uncle Sam doesn't play that. All right. He's like, hey, listen, you don't have my money, we're coming for your house. So you can actually help a homeowner by, instead of them having this debt and losing their house to tax defaults, which somebody's going to end up, you know, buying it at the auction for $1,500, you could actually structure the deal where in the money that they'll make on selling their property, they'll be able to pay those taxes off. And once again, you'll get a cheap property that you can go ahead and pick up and wholesale to another buyer. All right. So definitely a great strategy to use. And you can get tax default leads by just going to your local courthouse and just getting a list from them. There's also list brokers that are out there that might sell some of them as well. But this is definitely a very motivated seller to target. Because you'd be surprised how some of these people are like even facing where they're going to lose their house in a month, and bam, you send them a marketing postcard or letter, and you come in and save the day. All right. Now, last but not least, see if I have enough space on the board. Probates. Okay. Now, many of you may have heard of probates. Some of you may have not heard of probates, but probates is basically where someone who passes away, unfortunately, They might not have filled out their will correctly for whatever reason. And it's it's not clear who's actually going to be the owner of this new asset, right? And so what has to happen is that they have to put the whole process has to go through a court system with the lawyers and things like that in order to be able to determine who's going to be the new owner of the asset. All right. And these can be different assets. It could be the house. It could be car. It could be, you know, belongings that are now all type of different things. And so a lot of people pass away without a will being filled out. All right. Think about it. Do you have a will filled out for yourself? If you don't, you need to. OK. And so what happens is a lot of these people that end up, you know, when it comes to daughters, sons, aunties, uncles, whatever, they end up getting this property. They have no real want, you know, of owning the property. Some of them don't even live anywhere in the same state. And now they have this asset that they have to take care of. Some of them can't afford it. Some of them don't want to be a landlord. Some of them just don't want to have that extra weight on their back. And so a lot of times they don't even know what the market value is or anything about prices. They are very hungry to get rid of the property. All right. Now, I'll be honest with you. You have to be very empathetic when contacting these people. You can't just hit them up and say, hey, look, I want to buy your house because I heard your grandma died. That's not the way you're going to get the property. But if you show some empathy and you send a nice letter, maybe send something out with a greeting card or flowers or something. I don't know. You can get creative. Then you can go out there and pick these properties up for 10, 20 cents on a dollar. I've done tons of probate deals, and I'm talking about the discount that I get on them is amazing. It's incredible. And the best thing about it, too, is that I get to help the homeowner get past his grieving part and letting this get behind them so they can move on with their life. All right. Now, the thing about probates is you got to know how to get them. All right. There's been a lot of different things, you know, as far as restrictions and things that they've put into place with, you know, trying to just go access them. Sometimes you can access them online, depending on your state. Sometimes you have to go into the local courthouse and they might ask you for certain things to figure out why do you need this information, right? But this is some real information. Sometimes they have social security numbers in there. But what I've done is I've actually put together a training course. It's called Courthouse Cash System. And actually what it does is it shows you how to find two of these motivated sellers. We talk mainly about how to find probate deals, how to go out and what to say to these sellers to make sure that you're empathetic, and how you can go out and lock these properties up 10, 20 cents on a dollar. As a matter of fact, we even show you how, even if the property is in the probate, we show you a strategy how you can get the lawyers to talk with the judges to release, you know, the property out of probate so that way you can go ahead and purchase it. In your case, contract it to wholesale it out. We also talk about how to find tax default leads as well, too. All right. This is all in our Courthouse Cash System program. All right. So if you want to learn more about that, there's going to be a link below somewhere on this video that you can go ahead and get access to that. And it's a fairly cheap investment, but we give you a lot of information and, you know, a lot of impactful strategies and ways for you to go out and start maximizing your success targeting these two leads, probate and tax default. All right, so go ahead, go to CourthouseCashSystem.com for that. And once again, I appreciate you checking in this video and look forward to serving you with more content, more training videos on a regular basis. All right, you be blessed. And remember my quote, don't live the dream, live your dream. I'll see you on the next one.